Hi, Sunshine. How are you?
Good.
So, can you tell me what was on your desk this morning?
A sticky note that was good.
Oh, and what made it good?
It was about my hair and all the good stuff.
Alright guys, so here is the kind table. And they have their notes waiting for them. And y'all, I got these off of Amazon if anyone is interested. I'll put a link in the description box below. I used to do like these cups with tissue paper, but this has been game changer. Super cute. They're like the little ticket holders when you go to restaurants for your with your table numbers. So cute. But anyway, here's Cooper's. So a little bit of happy. All right, guys, it is Monday morning and I am here to spread some love to my little firsties. Many of you have asked me in previous videos, Miss May, how do you establish those relationships with your students? Now, I've been here on YouTube now for about a year and a half or two, so you might not have seen videos from my past. So I'm sharing with you different ways that you can start building those relationships with your kids. One is basically just what I like to do and what I've done for many years is write on a sticky note just a quick little positive something to them and stick it on their desk. Two, you can get a dry erase marker and you can just write something on their desk positive to keep them motivated, to keep them feeling good. Or you can get really fancy and you can print on sticky notes. They look like this. Let me zoom in. And so it's just a sticky note. So what I do is take the sticky note off and stick it on their desk. Now, people often say, I don't have time for building a relationship with my students. I don't have time for that. We have to get things done. It's all about academics and that's fine and dandy. But to me, building those relationships with your students is very, very crucial and very, very important. I know for me personally, as a person, as a teacher, I don't trust everybody right off the gate. We have to build that relationship in order for me to trust people, and I think that's like that for many people. You have to build a relationship in order to trust someone, and I feel like our students, they have to trust us, and in order to trust us, we have to build a relationship with them. And to me, when people say I don't have time for that, or I don't want to do that, or that's not my job, I just feel like there might be something going on personally on the inside with them. Because for me, I love making people happy. I love spreading positivity to people. It just makes my heart happy. It makes me happy. It makes me feel good. And to say that I wouldn't want to make others feel good or others feel happy, especially children, there's something going on, I personally feel. Relationships are key. I will stress that until I am blue in the face. To the day I die, I truly will stress that building relationships is so important. Like, who wouldn't want a nice sticky note or a nice note on their desk? I mean, I know I love it when my principal puts positive notes in my mailbox. Like, it makes you feel good. It gives you a little extra boost. And sometimes we just need a pick-me-up. So I like to start the week off with positive notes, and I just don't do them in the morning. Like, sometimes I'll do them when they're out at recess, or sometimes I'll do them at the end of the day. There's just many different ways, different types, different things. You don't have to stress about like overdoing it. You don't have to stress about like how cute it is. It's not about how cute it is. It's about what the message says and the purpose on why you're doing it. Now, sometimes I do like to get cute like this and put a little melon heads on the sticky note or change the sticky note. I do. It's just me and my personality. But a lot of times I just get a regular sticky note, write on it real quick, or get my dry erase marker and write on their tables something positive. So If you haven't started, I would definitely highly suggest you leaving them positive messages and be consistent with it, because if you're not consistent with it, then it doesn't seem or feel real. So don't do it just to do it. Do it because you really want them to feel good. You really want them to know how much you love and care about them. So until the next time, guys, forget to stay prayerful and thankful, and don't forget to always pray, because God will always make a way. Love you. Bye. So can you guys tell me what was on your desk this morning when you came to school?
A sticky note.
And what kind of sticky note was it?
A happy sticky note.
And what was on that happy sticky note?
Like all the things that you love about us.
Yeah.
Like all the firsties.
So, and how does that make you feel when you get a note on your desk from Miss May?
Yeah, it makes me happy, and it makes me like smile.
Oh, and it makes you smile. What about you, Firstie? How's it make you feel?
Happy.
Happy. Hi, Sunshine. How are you?
Good.
So, can you tell me what was on your desk this morning?
A sticky note that was good.
Oh, and what made it good?
It was about my hair and all the good stuff.
And all the good stuff about you. How did that make you feel this morning?
Amazing.
Amazing. Do you love it when Miss Meg puts sticky notes on your table?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why do you like it?
Because I know that means it's not just about bad stuff. Every time it's about good stuff. Oh.